Hey, good morning, guys. I hope you're having a great day. Thank you for joining us on One Coin Only. If you're awake, I hope you've got some Pop-Tarts toasting. You got your breakfast ready. We're going to be on for the next couple hours, guys. We're going to do some NES to warm up the day, guys. We're going to start with Kid Icarus as our warm-up game. And then as our bonus for the first time in like a year, we're going to play a game called Section Z. Section Z is a lesser-known Capcom game. It's kind of like a shooter slash maze runner game. It's actually really, really decent. And I can't wait to show you guys. That's what we're going to do this morning. Thank you for coming in. We got Barb. Good to see you. Yeah, no worries, my friend. We'll catch you afterwards. Thank you for hanging out. We got Alan. We got Zaya. We got Rudy, Cody, Steve, Matt, Josh, Kat, Lauren, Nick, and Brett. Appreciate you guys very, very much. With that being said, we're going to get started right now. And yeah, we're going to be on for 2 hours. So let's turn this TV down. You guys are going to get about 2 hours from me, and then I'm going to head to bed so I can get a full night's sleep. I've got a lot of hard games to play for you after Combat of the Mortals, and I'm just definitely going to have to rest up for that. Oh, good on you, Brett. I hope you enjoy. How you going, Jessica? Good to see you. Let's get this sumbish done, hey? So big raise your hands in the air if you grew up and you actually played this game. Zaya says you're watching on YouTube. Yeah, nice. Yeah, we are on Facebook and YouTube this morning. You can watch the platform of your choice. And we're going to play this from start to finish today. Probably usually takes me about 90 minutes to beat the game. First half of the game is the longest. Yeah, but what you got to realize, Payron, is since I'm using save states, if I take a wrong direction, I can basically save myself. You know, the joys of save states, Payron. You know this. You know this already, bro. There we go. Got some hammers there. Hey, going, Daniel. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in, brother. You all good, man? Buckety, buckety, buckety. Excuse me. There we go. I'm going to go back this way. Steve says he never owned this one. You played it at your buddy's house. Yeah, my auntie owned this game, and a year later, I can't remember if she gave this one to me as a hand-me-down, or, no, I think she gave it to me as a hand-me-down after she got rid of an NES, and then after she got rid of her NES, she got another one, and then she got rid of that NES and gave me more hand-me-down games. She was very impulsive, you see, come to think of it. You know, these video game consoles, she doesn't play games anymore, but back in the day, these video game consoles were like a new toy to her, and she'd get bored with them, like, I don't know, 5 minutes and give me the hand-me-down stuff. Lamont, good morning. Oh, Lamont, I haven't checked yet, brother. I've been so busy ever since I stopped streaming. I haven't gone in my inbox yet. I'm probably not going to check my mail until tomorrow. But thank you for letting me know. Lamont, this one's going out to you. Thank you, Lamont. I really appreciate it. I'll check that ASAP. After the stream, I'm just going to go to bed. That's all. How you going, Joanne? Good to see you. And you having a good morning? Thank you for coming in. I think there's something in here we may need. Oh, that's ambitious. Okay. Daniel says he's doing well. That's away. I don't know which one this little midget thing's going to be in. We can guess. I don't know. I have a feeling he's going to be on the bottom left. I don't know. Well, I was freaking wrong, wasn't I? Oh, gosh. I love this game. I don't know why I love this game so much. It's not in most people's top 10 or 20 lists. But when I own an NES or any NES stuffs, this is a must-own for me. And Dwayne, Daniels... Oh, I don't know if Dwayne's in here yet. I think he's still finishing up his stream. When you see the room numbers bounce up all of a sudden, that means he's raided us. Oh, gosh. Let's keep going on this wonderful journey that is Kid Icarus. We're just going to keep jumping up the screen here. And, you know, unfortunately, Kid Icarus has got wings, but he don't know how to fly, so he's a pretty useless angel, if we're just going to put it out there right now. Ugh. So what's everyone got planned for the day? What is everyone's plans? movies, games, all that kind of thing. Oh, here we go. Well, that's alright. All that trouble just for one love heart, hey? See, that's why love is such a hassle. I had to fight for that love heart. That's terrible, Rick. That was really... My bad. Get away from this sumbish. Oh, go away. Oh, come on. Alright, we're out of here. Hey, Pablo, good to see you. I watch you now here because I can see you on your TV with... Okay, yeah, no worries, man. That is why we dual stream, Pablo, so you've got the choice. I know a lot of people that still like YouTube. Catherine says, your plan is to create my character. You'll eventually get there, huh? Don't go to too much pressure, girl. Oh, you like the 3DS Kid Icarus game? Yeah, there's a special version of this game on 3DS. I don't know how many people still use their 3DS. But there's a version of this on 3DS where you can play it in 3D, but it's also got different backgrounds and stuff. It's really neat. I've also got this on the 3DS. Isaiah says, you're getting ready for the cold weather. You guys are still cold this time of year? We got Robert here. Good to see you, Rob. Thank you for coming in. Ah, on Soul Calibur. On number six, I'm guessing, Kat. And we got Jeremy. Good to see you, Jeremy. We got Mel in here from Kid at Heart Gaming. Oh, always good to see you, Mel. Thank you for hanging out. And how about you, Mel? Are you having a good start to your morning? As I said, I'm coming down pretty hard from this energy drink I had earlier today. So I am just giving you basically all my reserves for the next 2 hours. Putting on a smile here. Man, there was a lot of excitement the last stream I did. Keep in mind, you guys have been asleep. I haven't. But man, this whatever Wednesday this week was five hours of craziness. Thank you to everyone again for contributing. That was incredible. But yeah, whatever Wednesday, and for good reasons. You know, I feel like whatever Wednesday is the stream I work hardest at every week. And yeah, man, it was crazy this week, wasn't it? It was unbelievable. Hey, going, Phil? Good to see you. Phil likes this game. Thank you, man. I'm glad to hear it, because this is one of my favorites as a kid. ML says you just woke up and you got your coffee. Yeah, I've been trying to do the whole coffee thing, and I still am, but I'm not going to lie, I do prefer the energy drinks. But I know that coffee's less bad for you. We got Daryl in here as well. Good to see you there, Daryl. Thank you for coming in. How you traveling? No, we're just doing the original one today. I didn't really feel like fucking around with any gimmicks today. Excuse my language. Here we go. It's 9 a.m. and I'm already going back, backity, back, 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 back. No. No, we're just playing the original one today. No gimmicks. As I said, I'm really looking forward to doing the bonus game, Section Z. Just hoping we don't get too stuck today. You know what, Jason? That's probably what it is. You know, well, it depends. Like, if I go to Gloria Jean's or Starbucks or something like that, the coffee's amazing. But if you're just having crappy at-home packet coffee, then yeah, absolutely, I prefer the aforementioned energy drinks. It's when you go to the proper coffee places that you prefer that. But, you know, I've got my garbage $2.50 for 10 packets. Well, you know where I'm going. Packet cappuccino crap. Anyway, back over here. No, I get that, Jason. I didn't have many people watch Final Fantasy VII with me, and I shouldn't be surprised. I shouldn't be surprised. I think it was for that reason. I know, forgive me. I can't help myself. Barkity, fuckity, excuse me. Oh my gosh, this is going crazy. Get out of here, Rick Dog. Excuse me. Oh, that was close. Oh, gosh. Gotta watch this hang time, man. Kid Icarus here doesn't exactly jump like Jordan. You've been meaning to try the Death Wish coffee. What the hell's a Death Wish coffee, if you don't mind me asking? I've never heard of it. We got Matt in here, too. Good to see you, Matt. You just downloaded the... Yeah, I wonder what they keep bringing... Yeah. Who knows, Dustin? That's a good question, huh? yeah. Just one of those, Hey, we got Chris in here. By the way, Chris says he still uses his 3DS. Sorry I missed your message. We got the tick rules in here. Yeah, we got the same lockdown precautions in Australia too. So Chris actually has a coffee machine in the beans. Yeah, I've got to get one and stop being lazy. Hey, we got April in here. Thank you for coming in, April. April, this, what are we going to do for April? How you doing, Sweet Pea? We've got 50 stars from April. Thank you very much, girl. How's the rest of your evening going? What are you up to for the rest of the night, apes? And Joanne says she's finally motivated to get out of bed and make some... Put on a pop for me, Joe, will ya? Oh, no. I mean, I'm sure you can FedEx me some coffee. I'm sure that works out, doesn't it? Maybe a canister of black coffee. I don't know. Oh, gosh. I like a nice coffee, but I can't be bothered making it. I'm lazy when it comes to the kitchen. French vanilla cream? Well, that does sound really nice. I do like when I drink coffee over here, like I don't mind a vanilla latte, I gotta admit. Or I don't mind the mocha jolt either. Oh, just watching me? Well, there you go. We're going back a little bit old school here today, apes. Sparkadoo. And yeah, I like the vanilla creamer. We actually put milk in coffee over here. Now I've had creamer before, and I know creamer's a little bit different. Oh my gosh, creamer is pretty amazing. I must say, we use this here. Yeah, so Pablo says he can't wait for Streets of Rage 4. Do you know the release date? Yes, I do. And it's subject to change, but at this point in time, Streets of Rage 4 is going to be released on the 23rd of April, unless something happens. So I'll be streaming Streets of Rage 3 all day long, my friends, the moment it's released. So yeah, every character all day long. How you going, Timmy? Good morning. Thank you for coming in. Welcome, welcome. Hot cocoa is all... I do like hot cocoa. In Australia, we do something called hot Milo. I think the little sumbish is going to be in the middle. Yeah, little sumbish is going to be in the middle. Yeah, see? The little sumbish is going to be in the middle. Fucking little sumbish wasn't in the middle. Sorry. Well, we got this. That's why you could use safe states. You could cheat this puzzle. And, I'm going to get a digital copy. Well, actually, I'm probably going to get both, to be honest, Nick. I'm probably going to get a hard copy to collect. And just a digital copy so I can play it before anyone. As I said, I've got to take advantage being Australian and everything, getting the game a day early. So, yeah, I'll probably get one of each. I'll probably get like a hard copy and just not open it, because I know they'll be pretty rare. There you go, we got my brother D-Wayne in here. Thank you so much for coming in and for the raid, sir. How you doing, man? D-Wayne was just doing an awesome Mortal Kombat stream, and I just want to remind you guys that if you follow both myself and Headlock Gaming, as well as Commodore 64 Bradigan streams every few days as well, between all three of us, guys, if you have us all followed, you're going to get like up to 16 hours of streams a day. We're all on all the time, so definitely if you want something to do, guys, follow all three of us, and How you going, Como? I hope you're doing well. That was something I really wanted to tell you earlier, but I've forgotten what it is now, so it can't be that important. Yeah. Oh, gosh. Yeah, nothing I've got to say is important, Como. Oh, 2-4. Yeah, that's a bummer. Yeah, exactly. Oh, well, we'll see how we go. See, those limited run games can be worth a lot of money. Because obviously not that many copies get printed. Oh, gosh. What else, guys? So, Chris says Death Wish coffee is supposed to keep you awake something like 48 hours. Fuck me, man. Really? So, wow. I didn't even know so much. Wow, how much caffeine is in that? That sounds like something I need to get me through a day of streaming. Excuse me, guys. Wow. Sorry, I did have some water before I came on. Hey, we got Perry in here from the Global Stream Machine. Thank you for that. Get back off, Amya. Oh, if you wanted a raise, you only had to ask, Commodore. You can have a raise. You only had to ask. There you go. Commodore's getting a raise. How much he gets paid is not your business, though. Only messing around. How you going there, Cecil? Good to see you. Not about the raise part, I mean. And here we go. What do we got over here? There we go, we're finally going to get to the dungeon levels, hopefully, as long as we don't die in this section. Oh, shit. That was close. Southern Bell Gaming says you want a raise? Well, there you go, she wants to get paid for being the cheerleader. Well, you know what, when one coin only is taking more money, Southern Bell Gaming will hire cheerleaders. How you going, Stacy? We've got the lovely Stacy Francois in here as well. Good to see you, Stacy. Do you like the way I say your name? She's probably going to be like, no, I don't, Rick. Hey, go on, Miko. Good to see you. Stacy's... Oh. Any other news? What have you been up to today, Stacy? Any plans for later in the day? Have you been up all night, or have you just gotten up? Because, like, man, it is very, very early in the morning in Texas, my friend Stacy. I'm very surprised you're here. Awesome to pay $5. Oh, gosh. I'm not doing too good this run. Again, I think the fatigue is hitting me a little bit. So, Catherine says she used to be a cheerleader back in the day in high school. Really? There you go. I know cheerleading's a big thing in the United States. And cheerleading's starting to get more popular over here. But not like in high school or university. Cheerleading over here is just more with national sports. But, I know the dance choreographer for our basketball and cricket teams. I've been working with her for years. She's a lovely lady. Well, I mean, kind of a lovely lady. We'll just leave that one there. Jared dropping the 50 stars. Jared, thank you very much, sir. Good morning to you. This one's gone out to you, Jared. We got Josh in here. We got Pat in here. And we got Andrew in here as well. Good to see you guys. Thank you very much, Jared. Oh, there you go. Yeah, I'm just going to leave that one alone. All right, we're going to try and escape the Eggmen here because they're a big pain in the balls, these guys. Let me tell you. Fuck-a-doo. Hey, we got Mod Michael in here. How you doing, Wolfman Gaming? Good to see you. Yeah, I think I've got to get up the top right now. There's that. Oh, dude. Okay, come on, Rick Dog. Fuckity. Get out of there, dude. So Matt says you're a nobody in high school. You know what? I was a nobody in high school too. And you want to know what, Matt? That doesn't even matter. You know why it doesn't matter? Because high school doesn't mean shit. So, you know, I wouldn't even worry about it, to be honest. I was very unpopular in high school, to the point where I was probably one of the most unpopular kids in high school, to be honest. I was a bit socially awkward, and it didn't help matters. You know, that's a whole different time. It doesn't mean anything now. Hey, going, George? Good to see you. We've got George over on the YouTube. Alex, good to see you, man. I feel like it's been a little while. Alex, this one's going out to you, my brother. Thank you very much for coming in. Where's this Russell Crowe screen? Here it is.
Oh my god, it's Russell Crowe!
Oh my god, it's Russell Crowe! Oh my god,
why don't you go flush yourself down a toilet, you cunt?
There you go. A little bit of an offensive screen. I love it, though. That's my humor. Wow, Stacy, I feel like there's more to that story that we need to hear. You know, Stacy's going to be like, what happens in high school stays in high school. As I said, that's all in the past, guys. You know, it's nothing to worry about now, my friends. Now, what'd you say? It's only 6:18 in California? Oh, there we go. We can go bathe in the hot sauna now. Fantastic. George says he's at work now to see... No, I understand. I hope everything's all right with you. Sorry to hear you're in the front lines. I mean, it's a double-edged sword. Like, I know how tough it is. Like, you're blessed to still have the work, but then you're in the front lines, and I just hope you're safe, my friend. Damn it, we'll try this again. Damn it, I must be missing the jump. There we go, we got that one. Oh, me neither, Nick. Me neither. But you know what? When it rains, it pours. As soon as I left high school, it was different. As I said, high school doesn't mean shit. Even the popular kids don't keep in touch with that many people after high school. Oh, gosh. Damn it, man. I'm really, really struggling with this one today. Oh, well. It's all right, Rick. Get your head in the game. True Lies is on telly? Oh, hell yeah. And what else have we got? I haven't watched a good movie in ages. I kind of feel like binge-watching movies sometime soon. What is this date that you speak of? Oh, I don't date anymore, Michael. I was just saying in Dwayne's stream just before, I'd rather live until I'm 80 than date and have a heart attack. That's kind of my outlook on it now. It's a very cynical outlook, isn't it? But it is what it is. Oh, here we go. We finally got the boss over, Mia. I'm gonna get that sumbitch. Come on, kill that sumbitch, dude. Oh, come on, Rick Dog. We got him. That's it. Tia Carrera. Oh, yes, I love Tia. You know how much I love Tia Carrera. She is a beautiful, beautiful woman. I'm sorry, Cat. Well, see, you know what? I mean, you're one of us now in the Sumbish Army, aren't you, Cat? You belong. You fit in. It wouldn't be the same without ya. How you going, Perrin? Good to see you today. Thank you for coming in. Welcome, welcome. Can we buy anything from here? I can't afford anything right now. I'm hoping there'll be a hot spring around the corner because I ain't got no health left. Oh, gosh. So we're going to be playing this whole game. As I said, Kid Icarus usually takes me about 80 to 90 minutes, which will leave us about 40 minutes for a little bit of a demo on Section Z. Basically, Section Z is a hybrid maze runner and shooter. Hey, going, Javier. Good to see you today. Welcome. Thank you for coming in. Yeah, we got him, Andrew. Better late than never, huh? Oh, gosh. Oh, Nick, I'm sorry to hear, my man. Hopefully you guys can sort it out, hey? Damn it. What else have we got? Everyone seems to be pretty chilled. That's a good thing. Glad everyone's chilled at this time in the morning. I'm a little bit too chilled. It's probably a good thing that I'm not too, like, boisterous at this time, because everyone's like, Rick, that's too much. I haven't had my coffee yet. You proud of me? Apart from that one little sequence, I haven't really yelled out a whole pile of facts yet. They're coming, though. They're coming. This game's going to get a little bit harder at one point. Barry says he loves this game. Me too, man. I don't know why I like this so much, but I always have. I've been playing this game for over 30 years now, Perry. I've been playing this game since 1989, if not earlier. Thank you, Kat. I'm glad to hear it. So what's been going on the Global Stream Machine? You guys been having anything going on today? Hey, Giancarlo's in here. Good morning. Thank you for coming in. Hey, Giancarlo, it's my pleasure. You guys like... No, I like to mix things up with the old and the new. I hope you guys like the next game, too. As I said, we got Section Z coming next. And tomorrow, after Combat of the Mortals, guys, I'm... Fuck off! Excuse me. As I was saying, After Combat of the Mortals tomorrow, guys, I'm going to be doing some Star Wars games. So I'm pretty excited for that, not going to lie. I'm going to be doing Super Star Wars. Then I'm going to be doing NES Star Wars. And if I can get it working properly, no problem. I may even do Rebel Assault 2. But we'll see how we go. Thank you, Mel. Just remember, girl, I'm only a sumbitch with a video game controller. But apart from that, we're more of the same than you realize. Kat says she loves Star Wars. Glad you could make it. There you go. Looks like we're going to get a power-up here. You know what I just realized this stage is? This stage is like a get-in-the-door simulator. It seems like every two steps there's a fucking door to go in. There you go. This is just one step away from being a talkie-talkie game. And you know what I say about talkie-talkie games. They're not for whatever Wednesday. Anyway. And then Stacy says, so Ricky, are you working on that sumbish, Oh, there's just one problem, Stacy. I don't got no abs yet. I've been enjoying my snacks too much. So, you'll probably see me in this calendar and you'll be like, why's that sumbish Rick got bigger boobs than me? So, you know, I've got to tone up a little bit first, Ace, and then I'll make a calendar for ya. I'm not even kidding. I was literally like within this close to joining a gym, and then it got shut down because of my Sharona. You know, but that's not no excuse though, because I could still be doing workouts at home, but I've been too lazy, straight up, so. The hardest part's getting started. It's alright, I'll get started soon. I'll stop putting it off eventually. Oh, there you go. Ricky's beer. Yeah. Hey, I'm a solid B cup, guys. Hey, I mean, if you can feel them, they're real, right? Yeah, they're real, all right. How you going, Enrique? Good morning. Oh, you want... Okay, well, what have you guys need? And then Stacey's like, damn it, I told you dad bods are in. Well, I mean, Leonardo, I'm not comparing myself to Leo, of course. I have a feeling it's got more to do with his money than his looks, but Leo's doing all right with the ladies, and he's certainly got a dad bod. Going back over here, damn it. You guys really know how to boost up a man's self-esteem. I really appreciate you guys. I always feel good when I talk to the Sunbish Army. Apart from a couple bad eggs, you're all wonderful people. So thank you very much. Now, I'm going to guess he's in the middle. He's in the middle. I'm going to guess he's in the middle this time. Fuck it, he's not in the fucking middle. There you go, I got it wrong, guys. I got it wrong. It's alright, we'll get it right this time. It's all good. Alright. There you go, I just said an F-bomb, guys, did you notice? I wouldn't worry about it, Matt. You know, I mean, I talk about that stuff openly, because it's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world, in the end, it's something you can, like, change. You know what I mean? So it's like, no big deal. You know, like, I'm like, I don't have to have boobies forever. We got this. Hey, go on there, Austin. It's lovely to see you. Thank you for coming in. Back over here. Well, there you go, the tick rules. The tick rules are saying some lame pickup lines. And Andrew, we got Andrew in here. Andrew says he's having breakfast. What's for breakfast, Andrew? Barkety off. All right, there you go. What are you eating, Andrew? Markety, excuse me. Oh my gosh. This is a weird conversation. Hey, I'm an open book for you guys. You know me. I'm no bullshit. I'm very transparent. Like, well, what you see is what you get with one coin. Lomont says you're definitely getting quarantined. Yeah, see, I think I'm finding now. This is the trap that I fell into. I stockpiled not too much food, but a little bit of food, but mainly junk food for the extra carbs in case we didn't have access to food. You know, you just prepared a little bit of emergency shopping. But now Australia's flattening the curve and everything seems all right over here. I've now been eating a whole pile of junk food because it's just here, and I've been boredom eating a lot. April says you want to. Good morning, Kid Jackson. Thank you for coming in, brother. We're just warming up with some NES, sir. A big thank you once again for yesterday, brother. You're incredible, man. And how's your morning going? Everything all right with you? Oh, gosh. As I said, I'm just glad that with everything going on right now, we're a place where you guys can unwind and escape and we can talk about things comfortably too without being negative. So Melissa says everyone needs a quarantine buddy to make sure you don't go crazy. Yeah, I mean, the only person I really talk to in the flesh is my flatmate, but lucky he's a stand-up bloke. So, you know, I try to at least bump into Ben. You guys have seen him in the chat here a couple times. I try to bump into Ben and at least say hello during the day. But apart from that, I'm not seeing anybody, obviously. So it can be challenging. How you going, JR? Good to JR likes the old Kid Icarus. Oh, I feel you. I'm sorry to hear. I understand what you mean. I'm really sorry. For my former roommate, Kelly. She's got a respiratory condition, and she has to still work at the reception in the hospital, and people are coughing on her all day, and, oh, man, she's like playing Russian roulette with her job, seriously. She'll end up on a ventilator if she gets something like this. Hey, we got Shawnee Sean in here. Wait. One coin is the same. Sean, now I know you're like in ground zero, brother. How are you and the family going? You guys alright? Just checking in on you, making sure you're okay. Thank you for coming in, Sean. It feels like we got a lot to catch up on. Yeah, that is true, April. Poor April's not in the world's best situation right now. But, you know, I'll leave that information for April to tell you if she wants to. Hey, how you going? We got Mr. Retro Wine here, Mr. Spinback Retro Gaming, guys. Don't forget to check out Yoda in your travels, everybody. How you going, man? Yeah, it's 30... I mean, you'd think I'd be a little bit better at this after 30 years of playing it, JR. That makes me feel really old. Yeah, good. Yeah, hopefully the curve in your neck of the woods starts to flatten too. I mean, you know, it's all over the news over here, brother. Hey, Leon, welcome back. New humor. Thank you, Leon. Good to see you again. We got Mr. Harvey in here as well. Thank you for hanging out, guys. Leon, this one's for you. Gonna crack open some bubbly. One.
There's a little guy in there. Can't even get proper olives, can ya? What else we got?
Oh! A little bit of the bubbly.
A little bit of the bubbly. Thank you very, very much, my sir. So, what's going on? Oh, gosh. All right, now what? As I said, there's only four worlds in this game. And now the first three worlds have three levels and then a dungeon. The fourth world is a standalone. So after we beat this stage... we are actually at the halfway point of the game. No, it's okay, JR. You know what they say, you're only as old as the girl that you feel. Wait, I'm not supposed to say that on stream. Scrap that. There you go, I'm being exposed for being a sexist pig now. I'm only playing, guys, don't take me seriously. Thank you. I was just trying to get a laugh, to be honest. I don't know if it worked or if it backfired. Lamont laughed. There you go. At least as long as I'm getting one laugh, I'm changing the world for the better. There you go. Rick's making a difference. Oh, gosh. There we go. Back over here. Hey, Brandon. Thank you so much. Brandon just dropped the 50 stars. Brandon, this one's going out to you.
Wait, hang on. What are we fighting about?
Thank you very much, Brandon. Timothy, you can see a one coin only versus headlock competition when I'm next in the United States. Now, I've mentioned it so many times, but I'll mention it again. Connecting to the east coast of the United States from Australia is very, very hard to get a stable connection. And Dwayne and I have tried to stream games together in the past, and it just doesn't work out. So, I can connect to the west coast of the US okay, but the east coast, the connection's just rubbish. Too much congestion. Well, thank you, I won't be disappointed. Hey, Harvey, thank you so much. Harvey just dropped 100 stars, so look at these all adding up. This is going out to you, man. Now, guys, don't forget, if I've got closed caption on, that's a new Facebook gimmick. You guys need to turn those off yourself. It's actually got nothing to do with me. So I think you're just going to click those triple dots, and then there's a drop-down button where you can turn off closed captions, I think. That's a Facebook gimmick, so fucking Facebook. Again. Francisco says, do people like you here? You get no welcome eye, Francisco. It's good to see you. Francisco, sometimes, you know, I miss messages while I'm playing a game. So all I ask is that you don't be needy, my friend. You just comment again. Copy and paste as your friend. And I'll get back to you eventually, good sir. You don't need to be like that. Hope you're having a wonderful start to your morning, Francisco. Ah, damn it. Oh gosh, keep going. So this is the last level before the dungeon. Actually, I really like the rest of the game from the next world onwards. My least favorite part of the game is the first half. Probably because the second half's a lot quicker. We're actually going for a quick time, guys. We're probably going to beat this in 75 minutes by the looks of it. I'm really, really looking forward to getting my new gaming computer after COVID-19, because I'll be able to... Oh, there you go. I just said COVID. I'm going to get demonetized on YouTube now. Anyway, oh well, bummer. Yeah, looking forward to getting my new gaming computer, because then I can finally stream at 1080 and 60 frames per second. And I'll get a new webcam for that computer as well. And then we'll be like top quality production. It's going to be pretty freaking awesome. I'll get some new art and stuff done too. We'll make this 1.0 only 2.0. Commodore, speaking of art, I need to talk to you, by the way. You know that little camera window that you've got, Commo? Did Craig make it, or did you get that done somewhere elsewhere? Because I need, I don't always want to use a green screen, Commo. Sometimes I want it to be a bit more personable. So, if you could let me know where you got your little camera window designed, I want to get one for myself as well. Just a heads up. So Pablo says you're going to do a free play only channel. What, you mean you're not going to have stars, or do you mean you're going to do arcade games? There's nothing wrong with making a little bit of... There's nothing wrong with making a little bit of income from your hobby, Pablo. As long as you're offering value, that's a thing. Like, I think the worst kind of people in the world are those that ask for cash but don't offer any value. You know what I mean? Yeah, Craig, mate. Yeah, I want one of those as well. Like, especially for when I'm playing things like Wii Sports and stuff and not using a green screen. That would really come in handy. So, yeah, okay. Might have to hit him up and be like, Craig, how much? I hope Cyclops Gaming is doing well. Guys, Cyclops Gaming is another great page. You can see Craig streaming almost every day of the week, doing all sorts of stuff. And don't forget to check him out for your art needs too. He's got some pretty cool things. This one's not going so good. Hang on, do I have any... I don't even have any health here. This sucks. So, alright, hang on. So, Kid Jackson says, what's on the agenda today? Good question. So, D-Wayne is doing Combat of the Mortals. And then I'm coming on with Star Wars. So, I'm going to do Super Star Wars. I'm going to do Star Wars on the NES. And if I can get it running and working, I'm also going to do Rebel Assault 2. So, we're just going to have a random Star Wars day today, my friend. Which I hope you approve of. Yeah. Well, hopefully if I'm nice to Craig for me, he'll do it. I know Craig's a busy man. Alright, back over here. Francisco says you're sleepy, you need coffee. We just had, just before you fuck it, Francisco, we actually had a very interesting conversation about that. But yeah, the less we talk about the fuck it right now, the better. Anyway, no, that's... Sorry, guys. I had to roll with it because I said the wrong thing. Is this the right way? I really hope this is the right way, man. 2, 3, 4. I think we can just walk past now. There we go, we got it. Oh, crap. I need a health, man. Ryan needed a health like last week. Barkity, bro. Oh, this is nuts. I've got like a teacup of health left. I don't want to start this level again. No bonus game after Section Z, Pablo. I've got to sleep. It's like, it's going to be like 1 a.m. here, bro. I need to sleep if I'm going to stream all day in the evening, sir. I appreciate your enthusiasm, though. Nah, I want to pay him. I believe in rewarding people for their time. You know me, Como. I'm stubborn like this. Oh, Kid Jackson says tomorrow he's going to be celebrating a quarantine birthday. Ah, oh, my man. It's a little bit rough to stay in the house, man. I apologize. Well, what do you got planned anyway? Hopefully you can make the most of it. What are you going to have, a cake or play some video games? Anything going to happen? That's all right. Push come to shove, you got nothing else to do. The Sunbish Army will make you feel special, my friend. Hang on 1 second. I'll get back to you on that one, Kid Jackson, anyway. I might wait to tell you that, actually. Keep you in suspense. You'll find something. Yeah, man, it's... Hang on 1 sec. Damn it, I didn't mean to do that. The whole situation sucks right now, but this is all only temporary. You know what, you'll just have to make up for it next year, Kid Jackson, and make it the best damn birthday you ever had, eh? We just got raided by a Bish. Who did we get raided by, Eric? Well, I like a Bish raid more than anyone. Headlock raid? Big thank you to everyone who just came in from Headlock Gaming. What an awesome son Bish that guy is. Thank you, Mr. D-Wayne. Pablo says he was really lucky to celebrate his birthday in February. And Josh says this game is so much fun, but sometimes you get stuck and frustrated. I'm kind of curious, quiet Josh. I don't think I've ever asked you the question, but what are your favorite NES games? If you had to take 5 NES games on an island with you, what 5 NES games would you pick? There you go. I'm asking you the hard questions, aren't I, Josh? I'm probably making it even harder for Josh because we call him Quiet Josh for a reason. He's going to be like, damn, is some bitch making me talk? Timothy dropping the 95 stars as well. Timothy, thank you so much. Timothy's like, is this asshole going to thank me or what? No, I don't think so. Of course I am. Sorry, brother. This is going out to you, Timmy. Thank you very much. Yeah, favorite original Nintendo games. Oh. Susan says her favorites are Dig Dug, XI Bike, and Mario. Ooh, guys, I don't look, you know what? I don't know if XI Bike would be in my top five, but it'd be very, very close to being in my top five. Oh! You absolute legend. Thank you, Quiet Josh. Kid Jackson, just so you know, Quiet Josh just sent a $2 super chat over on YouTube, and Quiet Josh just said, this is so you can do the It's Your Birthday screen for Kid Jack. Man, that is really, really nice of you, Joshy. Thank you so much, man. I've got a little something in mind for Kid Jackson for his birthday, but I'm going to tell him on the day. But, Joshy, thank you very, very, very much, man. I'm just going to find where I put that now. I've got so many of these bloody screens here now. It's your birthday. We gonna party like it's your birthday. We gonna sip a card like it's your I'm probably birthday. Not going to watch that one, Pablo. No, not that it doesn't interest me. I just probably won't get around to it. There you go. Kid Jackson said a very big thank you, Joshy. Yeah, no, I got something planned for your birthday, Kid Jackson, but I'm gonna... Just something little, but just something to let you know how much I appreciate ya. Oh gosh, where are we gonna go now? Is this the right way even? I think this is the right way. This is late night stream. My brains are starting to get a bit scrambled now. Oh gosh. So Timothy says if you had to take five games, Super Mario, Zelda 1, 2, Dodgeball, and Spy Hunter. Oh, if I never played Spy Hunter again, I wouldn't really be upset about it. Yeah, there was a lot of WWE talent releases. I feel sorry for everybody. I feel sorry for all the talent, all the staff. I even feel sorry for WWE because this is a real hard situation for them to be in. I know we give WWE a lot of criticism for being heartless at times, but even if they are a company made of stone, this can't have been easy for them to do. This is a very hard situation for everyone. Well, there you go. Alan says Metroid, Zelda 1, Mario 1. See, a lot of people pick Super Dodgeball. I really don't care for that game that much. But the other ones I can kind of feel you on. So, Joshy says his top five favorite NES games are Star Tropics, Festus Quest, Dragon Warrior 1. Wow, there you go. The Dragon Warrior games, Kung Fu and Final Fantasy. Well... We can bond over Kung Fu and Final Fantasy, because I think all those on NES were pretty incredible. You can keep the other ones to yourself. No, let's try this again. I died, because I wasn't paying attention. So we're going to have a health spring here soon, guys. I think. I'm hoping. Shitballs, man. Get out of... Dude! Oh my gosh, this is starting to really irk me. Fuck off. Maybe I could just shoot these things. You see? Oh my gosh, these are really irking me right... Fuckity, fuckity, fuck, man. Excuse me, but that's how I'm feeling right now. They say you're gonna be true to your emotions. Oh my gosh, and right now I'm feeling the facts right now. Alright, there we go, we got this. Get back in here. That's not fair, Pablo. I don't think Roman gets... Fucked! I don't think Pablo gets nearly enough respect. I think Seth Rollins is the one that gets on my nerves. I don't think he lacks talent, but I think he lacks ethics. Oh, gosh. So Phil says if you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball. I need to put that screen back up eventually. I've got a dodge ball, thank you, screen. Oh, very nice, George. I just read your list too. I used to love Blades of Steel, but I could never win any freaking fights, man. Hey. Joshy says Festus Quest without save states is impossible. Yeah, the anger is real in this one. I do apologize for my colorful language. The good news is it's a free part of the show. gosh. All right, back out here. We going the right way? I think so. So Richard says this game looks hard. Oh yes, it is, bro. It's one of NES's finest. You know, and this is coming from someone that makes it look easier than most people. 30 years, mate. It's still a challenging game. Phil says I look a bit tired. Yeah, I know, guys. I do apologize. I'm not good at hiding it. I'm burning the candle at both ends a little bit. But what's most important, guys, is even though I don't always have the energy I like, my spirits are still high, and I'm still going to be bringing you the streams. I'm just sorry if they're not all as energetic as each other, but I ain't fucking going nowhere, mate, so don't worry about that. I really like Star Tropics as well, I just haven't learned how to beat that game. Can you beat Star Tropics, Josh? You might have to walk me through one day. Actually, poor Josh probably won't raise his hand for that, because we all know how I treat people that try to help me with games. Oh, here we go. Oh, damn, my little midgets just got shot. Wait, I'm not allowed to say midget in 2020, am I? Whoops. Oh, well, it is what it is, isn't it? Back off, I'm ya. Come on, Rick Dog. Oh, no. Come on. Oh, my midget's got... I just said it again. It's like, Rick, do you never learn? Alright, I need to shoot him like another 40 times. Nick says, why not save? I've been saving plenty. What the fuck are you on? How many times do you expect me to save? Sorry about it, Nick. Oh, gosh. Quiet Josh says he's pretty good at Star Tropics. I got up to World 3, or Area 3 or 4, I think. And then I started getting stuck at those, you know, those cryptic puzzles that the game is filled with. Yeah, I never made it the whole way through. I made it about 40% through, I think. What was that area after the graveyard, I think? What's that, like a third of the way through, 40% through? I think you know the one I'm talking about. Oh, thank you, guys. We got Marco with the 50 stars. And Timmy also with 50 stars. Timmy says, don't feel too bad. You've never beaten Star Tropics either. You save the baby dolphin and you get lost. Yeah, screw that freaking baby dolphin. And screw Taylor Swift too. Because I'm trying to save most of my helpers, Nick, for level 3, which is probably the harder one. That's actually a good question. Level 3 is the hard boss, so I try to have most of them on that one. But mind you, I do have a lot of mallets. I didn't realize how many. Yeah, Mel's a professional streamer, guys. You gotta check Mel out one of these days. Our friends at Kitten Hard Gaming. So we've got Mel. We got David, we got Truman. Who else is on Kid at Heart Gaming? I know there's three of yous. Forgive me for not remembering the rest. This is like an action RPG. Well, it's more of an action adventure game, but it gives the illusion of being like an RPG. It's more of an action adventure game, I think. Oh, you're going to stream on Global Stream Machine as well. Well, look at you getting around, Mel. And I don't mean in that context. That sounded really bad, didn't it? Hey, we got Josh in here from Player 40 as well. Good to see you, man. How you doing, brother? I was actually grinding Resident Evil 3 all night, Josh. I finally unlocked everything I'm going to use. I got everything. I got something like another $40,000 tonight. There's only like 5 achievements I don't have now, so I'm pretty over the moon. There we go. This is the final. So we got this world's got 3 levels, a dungeon, and then after this, guys, we got just one stage, which is like a big gigantic boss run. So if I was to guess, I think we are about 25 minutes from the finish, guys. No, JR says he picked Metroid, Blaster Master, Zelda, Mario, and Turtles. Well, no wonder you like One Coin Only Stream so much. We play those games. Makes sense. Oh, Thomas as well. Gotcha. Thomas is a great guy. I didn't realize he was on Kid at Heart Gaming as well. Excuse me. Back off, I'm ya. So anything else, guys? Anything else new? Something that I don't know yet? I always like the One Coin Only gossip, guys. As long as it doesn't ruin any friendships, of course. But you're the face of King at Heart Gaming because you're pretty and you have boobs. Oh, yes, boobs. The weakness of every full-blooded man. I'm gonna put up the crucifix and I'll be fine. I'll be okay. Yeah, oh, I was gonna say, how did you go with you had to do Blaster Master today for what yesterday Barkadied. For whatever Wednesday, right, Dwayne? We got Mr. Headlock Gaming back in here. Are you coming back on Headlock Gaming today, Dwayne? Or are you done on your page? And so Sean says, top of the pornography to you from... Well, I mean, I'm sure there's a lot of people looking at RedTube while they're bored stuck at home. I'm just saying. How you going, Sean? Good to see you. Good morning to Jado as well. Thank you for coming by, man. Steven says, do I still watch AEW? Yes. But I haven't watched it the last couple weeks. I'm not watching a whole lot of wrestling right now. I'm just really struggling to get into the empty arena stuff, you know what I mean? Even though every company's doing the best they can, I'm kind of struggling to watch the full shows right now. It's just a bit, eh, you know what I mean? Barkadied. All right, back over here. Well, there you go, guys. So you've heard it yourself. Dwayne's going to do some Mortal Kombat 9 later today if you want to check out Mr. Headlock Gaming. And then we're going to be back on One Coin Only from 6 p.m, guys. So there you go. You know the schedule today, guys. Yeah, we're so close to the end, everybody. Then I'm going to be able to showcase Section Z for the first time in a very long time. I'm very excited and nervous at the same time to do Section Z today. Yeah, I think so, the tick. Yeah, I know how much it grinds your gears, man. I don't know too many people that are as dedicated to Mortal Kombat as you. You know, the only way you could be better at Mortal Kombat, Dwayne, is if you played 18 hours a day and you didn't make a living. Unfortunately, the gaming industry is not fair, is it? Like, and honestly... Like, seriously, the best gamers are the ones that play 18 hours and don't have any responsibilities. I mean, it's not cool. I wish there was a way to have, like, a handicap or something. I think that's why I keep missing you, Mel, because it's already, like, 12 in the morning here. And, that's just one of those problems, you know, time zones and everything. Otherwise, I'd be in and cheering you on. It's alright, we'll cross paths eventually, girl. I'm not tiptoeing around you forever. I'm gonna buy this little water. Oh, gosh. That was supposed to be... Oh, I know what you meant. Very nice. Metroids, yeah, I mean, don't forget the same development team that made the original Metroid made this game. So, you know, they would have, you know, especially with these early NES games, there were some shared assets, you know what I mean? You can see a lot of similarities in this with Metroid, like with just some of the colors and a couple of the sprites. Little subtle similarities. How you going, Colin? Good to see you. Thank you for hanging out. I'm doing well, man. I am doing fantastic. Thank you for asking. I don't like this black market salesman. His stuff is too expensive. Fuck him. Alright, back over here. Oh, what about you, Colin? What do you got planned for the day? I hope quarantine day is not going too bad. Hope you're staying safe and healthy. I'm kind of curious, if you don't mind me asking, Colin. How are you getting your food? Are you able to get it delivered? Or are you actually heading to the store when you have to? One more day. It's going to be a big celebration, isn't it, JR? There you go. Just go in the room simulator. 2020 freaking edition here, man. There you go. Now's not the time to have a vacation, bro. You have to wait. You have to wait till my Sharona is over. You can't have a spa bath. Man, gosh, how I'd love to have a spa bath, man. It's the only luxury I want. So Susan says she's going to help Mum today and take your Grammy to the doctor. Oh, good on you, Isaiah. Yeah, I know how Animal Crossing works in real time, hey. The anticipation and the excitement that comes with Animal Crossing is huge. But it also, the anxiety of waiting kills you too. Animal Crossing is kind of like a life management sim, Dwayne. So what you do is you're this young boy that moves into this brand new town. And what you got to do is make friends with the neighbors. You're like appointed mayor of this town. And you got to make friends with the neighbors who all happen to be animals. And you can do little things for them like favors and visit them and play games. You can do things like fishing, collect items, and it's basically a living, breathing world where you can, like, you know, you're only limited by your imagination. And the reason I like Animal Crossing so much is it just reeks of innocence, and it's just a nice game to play to relax and just forget how crappy the world really is at the moment. So the only reason I haven't picked up Animal Crossing yet is just because I bought other games this month, but I'm probably going to pick up a copy. And technically, you're appointed mayor against your will. Now, that's a nice game. I heard this latest Animal Crossing game's a little bit more like Minecraft. Is that correct? Like, I heard there's a lot more building in it. Yeah, I mean, the original, it was more about management than Minecraft, but I heard that they added more Minecraft elements to the new one. If I play a Minecraft game, I actually prefer Terraria, to be honest. And the last ever expansion for Terraria is actually about to come out. Oh, Timmy, thank you, man. Timmy dropping the 200 stars. Timmy says you can't wait to get that PS4. Man, I can't wait to play you in some games, Timmy. This is going out to you, my bro, Seth. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you, Inu. Appreciate it. Gotcha. Chris says he loves Minecraft. I really, really enjoy Minecraft too. I just don't have those hours to dedicate to it anymore. If, you know, the thing is, my community doesn't really like watching Minecraft streams. And if I'm going to spend hours and hours on a game, I feel bad if I'm not turning the camera on. So I kind of have to sacrifice Minecraft. And that's probably part of the reason I don't have Animal Crossing yet, for that same reason. You know, it's different for a streamer. You know, when you're playing games as a streamer, you feel guilty when the camera's not on, you know? Mel doesn't know what Minecraft is. Can someone explain it? And Marco says, just wants a replay of your request. Missed it live. And thank you for playing RC Pro-Am. Oh, Marco, no worries, man. RC Pro-Am's one of my favorites. I do have to apologize a little bit, Marco, because I had a bit of a tough run of it last night. I usually do a bit better, but you know what? It happens. The rose. I cannot. You probably heard a lot of rage. It needs, must wither. Mr. Crusher? Thank you very much, Marco. Much appreciated, my man. And we got Shane in here. Good to see you, Shane-o. Thanks for hanging, my friend. Oh, I'm going to scratch my eyeball. JJR said, yeah, that scene's a classic scene, isn't it? Is that like a rite of passage? Is it player 40? Oh, gosh, here we go. All right. So we only got like two levels left, including this one, guys. This is almost over. So how long have we got in the clock? Yeah, it looks like this is going to be like one of those 75-minute runs of Kid Icarus today. There you go, we smashed it. So hopefully I can give you guys enough game time on, trying to get the hot spring. How you going, Jason? Good to see you. How you doing, Jason? He is now a man, yeah. Oh, shit. I know, right? Welcome to the club, son. I love you, son. And then if he's playing Minecraft and instead of raging, he just goes, oh, poop. You'd be like, he's not my son. So, Timmy says it's way past his bedtime. So, are you going to bed, Timmy? Or are you staying up a little bit longer? That is the question. Although, I don't want to make you exhausted for work. This is going out to you, Timmy. I just realized we haven't done this one in a bit. Thank you so much for the 200 stars, sir. Thank you, man. I'm so glad that you guys are following both me and Dwayne every day. Because there you go, you got your 12 plus hours a day of streaming just from us alone, you know? How you going, Jeremy? Good to see you this morning. Oh, fuckity, Jeremy! You fucking made me die, Jeremy. Fuck. No, I'm just kidding. No, Jeremy, though. Seriously. Yeah, I just felt in the mood tonight, man. I was actually going to do Smash Brothers on the Wii because my copy just arrived. But I was a bit too tired to practice that today. Plus, I had some resi grinding to do. So that might be tomorrow's game, but we'll see. So, Timmy says you're falling asleep. Don't want the phone to fall on your face again. No, it's a very nice face, Timmy. I want you to look after yourself, bro. Oh, gosh. Jason says it's 10. What time is it my time? It's 12:08. 12:08 in Australia, my friend. In the morning. So Pablo says, is Animal Crossing like Stardew Valley? A little bit, but with less of that kind of stuff, if that makes sense. It's more a... See, Animal Crossing's more of a social experience than a simulation, but it does have some stuff like Stardew Valley, just a few things. It's hard to explain. There's, you know, fucking man, damn, I wasn't concentrating. There's nothing really much quite like Animal Crossing, to be honest. It's kind of its own thing. It's like a social simulator. Like, it's got the social and the life management stuff. So it's hard to explain. You've got to really just try it for yourself. Yeah, man, the phones, Timmy, phones are getting pretty big these days. Like, when they fall on the face, they don't tickle. I've been screwing up, guys. I've been fuckitied. I've been fuckitied for starters. We'll start with that. I've been forgetting to smash these statues because I've been in... Oh, man. That's what happens when you sleep in. Fuck off, mother bitch! That's what happens when you sleep in and don't pay attention. Yeah, good on you, Colin. Alright, we got this. So, Mel says she's gonna shower and stuff. Check your messages when you're done. Thanks for being you, man. Have a good one. Mel, I hope you enjoy your relaxing shower. We'll see you, well, we'll probably hopefully still be on when you get back anyway. Enjoy, my friend. What do you call being a senior? Isn't it just called being a senior? What am I missing? Isn't it just called senior year? Oh, there we go. We made it. Out of here we shall go. I think the end ex. Oh, bro, there's more eggplant. Damn it, I tell you what. Can you imagine if Veronica was in here right now? I'm just saying. Can you imagine if Veronica was watching this stream? She wouldn't know what to do with herself. You can show her the playback of what I just said. She'll probably laugh. Hey, we got King Kush in here. Good morning to you, King Kush. Thank you very much for coming in. I can't afford anything right now. Hang on, maybe I can backtrack and just get a health. How much will that... No, I can't be bothered grinding this much. We're just going to try and get this boss with what we got. I think he's just on this other side. I think we can do it. Here he is. This is the boss they call Pandora. I don't know why they call him Pandora, but that's who he is. Ah, damn it. That sucks. Come on, Rick Dog. We have to shoot him like 50 times. God damn, my dude's dead. Oh, my other dude's dead. Man, the little guardians are freaking useless, man. The guardians in this really, really suck. So he's gonna take about another 25 hits. There we go. Oh, crap. That was close, wasn't it? Fuckity, man. Those little balls do a lot of damage, too. Colin says you tried and tried and you can't play. Man, I couldn't get past the first world when I first started playing this for months. And then, I don't know, when I was a kid, all of a sudden, one day, it just started to click. You know, I find that's the way with these retro games. You suck, you suck, you suck, you suck, you suck. And then one day, it just starts to click a little bit. And I mean, that was always a fascinating thing about when I played these as a kid anyway. We got him. Here we go, the final level, guys. I'm gonna have a quick water before that. Don't forget, Section Z straight after this, guys. We'll do that just for a little bit, for about 40 minutes. Probably won't have the patience to play the full game, guys. Some days I give you more than 2 hours at this time slot, but I really need to go to bed. Trying to be energized. As I said, especially tomorrow, I'm doing a big Star Wars themed stream for you guys after Combat of the Mortals, and those games are fucking balls hard. So, I want to be prepared for that, son bitch, let me tell ya. How you going, Payron? Good to see you this morning, man. Everything alright with you, sir? Hey, we got Errol in here. Good to have you, Errol. How you hanging, man? Everything good with you? Errol, I hope you are staying healthy and safe, my friend. Oh, there you go. Colin says he can actually play Metroid Piece of Cake. I'm wondering what's harder. I would actually... What do I think is harder, this or Metroid? If you're taking out the save state element, I think Metroid's actually harder in this game. I think if you can play Metroid, Colin, you can play this. Mind you, as far as time goes, it takes me equal amount of time to beat both, but this one's linear, Metroid isn't. You can get lost easy in that game. Yeah, that's exactly why I'm getting a big night's sleep. That's why I didn't do Star Wars today. Well, actually, I mean, yesterday I was going to do Star Wars, but I just did some NES stuff instead because I was freaking wrecked. But no, I'm going to be prepared this time. Peyron says you're waiting on Adventure Island 2 in the mail. Man, I wish I still had my physical copy of all my NES games. I had that one. Oh, crap. As I said, I think the next console I'm collecting for is for Dreamcast. I'm gonna see if I can get a cheap bundle. Yeah, I'm gonna probably try and get a cheap bundle tomorrow. Am I ready for Section Z? I don't know, but I'm gonna give it my best shot, JR. We'll give it my best shot. I think with save states I'll be fine for at least 30 minutes. Once it starts getting harder as bold, then I'll disconnect. Yay, orange with a skin took multivitamin flaxseed oil. I don't know how to pronounce half that stuff, but you know what? That answers my question. It sounds like you're keeping healthy, Errol. Did I ever watch the movie Fargo? I know what that movie is, but I've actually not seen it, I don't think. No, I haven't. I have heard of that one, actually. That's a PlayStation 2 game, if I'm not mistaken, right, Isaiah? I think I used to have a copy in my collection when I was buying and selling, but I never tried it for myself. It was a PS2 game, right? Look up that Dreamcast with SD card reader mod. Can I get one of those on eBay, Dwayne? Or is that only like a... Like, where can I get one of those? Because obviously I want a Dreamcast with that. And, Or can I just get one separate? Or do I have to get one that's installed? Like, how do I get it? Can I get an external one, or do I have to get it put in? Yeah, see, Dreamcasts in Australia are really expensive. They're a lot cheaper in the United States. Over here, they go for about 200 Australian, so what's that? About 130 or 40 US, so they're like over double the price in Australia. I'd prefer an American one, actually, but... Yeah, it's alright. I'll see what I can come up with. I don't think I'll be able to... So, can you get an external... Can you get it as an external add-on, or does it have to be built into the Dreamcast? Because if that's the case, I might have to order one from the US and pay the postage. I may as well just, you know, by the time I pay the postage, I may as well just get my bundle from the US if it's going to work out to be the same price anyway, and just get all the add-ons for it. Nintendo 64 stuff is really expensive over here too. There we go, I wasn't even paying attention, guys. That's how muscle memory this game is. Oh, gosh. Yeah, maybe I should just buy it done already, Dwayne. Alright, I'll look into it anyway. Man, thank you for letting me know. Alright. There we go, we're gonna load up the next game, guys. That is done. That was Kid Icarus, guys. We just made that game our bitch. And now this the irony is the next game's gonna make, you know, in Soviet Russia, game makes you the bitch. Alright. Here we are. Music in this game is really neat. Pablo, if I can get it working and find a copy, it's not out of the realm of possibility. Oh, here we go. How many of you guys have played this game before? This is one of the lesser-known Capcom games on NES, but it's actually really good if you got the patience with it. It's like a maze-running game. You've got to do all these shooter levels, and then you've got to pick which direction you go until you find the exit. If you go the wrong way, you'll go backwards. It's like a maze-running game. It's pretty neat. Nice concept. I've been looking forward to playing this one again for a long time. Yeah, Mikey, back at it as always. This is our morning warm-up today. Hey, JR, my pleasure. I'm not sure which way to go. I've already got Ready to Rumble 2 on PlayStation 2. The only reason I've not streamed Ready to Rumble 2 is I feel like the career mode in that game is ruined by boring mini-games, and that's why I haven't streamed Ready to Rumble 2. I was going to stream it for you guys, and then I thought it has some massive pacing issues because you've got to do all those compulsory mini-games, and I was just like, you know what? No thank you. Yeah, man, it's been a little minute, Perry. Let's see where we go. Oh, Como says you remember this game back in the day. I think number 6 is the right way here. This reminds you of Bureau Fighter was also a game that I used to own. Farkity, fuck off, excuse me. I forgot I've got rapid fire here, so Farkity. Yeah, I owned Bureau Fighter was a bitch, man. Oh my gosh, that game was hard. I think I got to the final level in that too. The boss fights in that were epic. Oh, well, that's a bit rude, JR. Funny guy. Here we go. Now we're going to work out which one to go in. Oh, there you go. Sylvain says ready to run. Is it really? I didn't even realize. So what's this one? Is this the right door? Number 8. I think number 8 is the right way here. Alright, here we go. I keep forgetting that I've got the rapid fire here. This is going to be, like, really handy. Oh, here we go. We got this. Gotta remember what button does what. Okay, cool. So there's like bosses in this and everything that will come up, and mini bosses, things of that like. So what Dreamcast titles am I looking forward to? Okay, so Royal Rumble. What was it? Royal Rumble? What's the game called? Blue Steel, I think. Royal Rumble, Blue Steel. Tokyo Extreme Racer, also known as Tokyo Highway Challenge. Probably Sonic Adventure. What else do I like on Dreamcast? Probably end up getting Dynamite Cop 2. We gotta do this again, guys. My bad. Tailmander is a good game, so is R-Type. This is Section Z, Errol. Starting to get a little bit stuck on this already. It's embarrassing. It's alright, we'll make it. You know, you can take many hits with the bullets, but if you hit the enemies themselves, it's like a one-hit death. It's pretty tough. As long as the enemies don't hit you, you're okay. Man, we got like super speed now. Clarkity, those things. Randy says Flake to Flake's a nice card game. How you been keeping? We got Pie Wizard over on YouTube. Pie Wizard, thank you very much for coming by. I hope you're doing well. Man, I am better than I deserve. I'm doing pretty good here, my man. I'm doing, barkity. Well, I was pretty... Bark. Okay, sorry, guys. I'm okay now. Dude, weak. I need a health pickup, guys. They're not dropping nothing. Oh, gosh. Thing is, if you die, you do spawn again at the start of the level. Oh, here we go, just wait for those sumbitches to piss off. Oh, we got him. Which way are we gonna go now? Yeah, the music in this is really good, hey. Thank you, JR. Oh my gosh, D-Wayne, that's a lot of money. So, Pie Wizard says he's doing great too. That's the wrong way. So where's this gonna take me? Here we go, Section 11. Alright, we're making it in there. I think there's like a mini boss battle here now. Oh, this is crazy. I can't handle this. Becky, can you handle this? Beyonce, can you handle this? One Coin, can you handle this? No, I can't fucking handle this. Oh my gosh. Oh, I see Sylvain. Gotcha. Is there a NASCAR game on Dreamcast? If there is, I want it. That's right. This is where it gets... Oh my gosh. What a freaking nuts game. Oh, where are you going? No! Oh, bro, you're not going to send me back to the beginning, are you? No way. Can I respawn here? At the start of the stage? Oh, dude, weak. Bro, I'm not going to go back to the beginning. Don't make me go back to the start. That would suck with no health. With no health, are you serious? Oh man. I'm just trying to work out how to get around. I'm trying to work out that there's a pattern to do this. I'm just trying to work out what the pattern is and then I won't get hit. Let's find out what the pattern is, guys. So like that. And then like this. Okay, well that works. Sort of. Alright, there you go, saving. I'm gonna have to save. Well, that works. Let's get them all to hit the bricks. Alright. by saving here. Alright, there we go, so like that. That's pretty straightforward, actually, once you figure it out. Oh, we got him. Okay, I didn't give up. You're proud of me, guys? I actually didn't give fuck off, you little munchkin. Oh my gosh, wide circles. There we go, we got it. So Joshua says, what kind of Dreamcast do I need? I need, I'll still get Indy 500 though, if there is one. I need a Dreamcast with an SD card installed. And, or at the very least, I need a Dreamcast with an HDMI converter cable. Like, I want to play Dreamcast and HDMI. Number 9. What's the other one? I don't know which one to go in. I'm just going to see. Which one you got, 9 or 10? Alright, let's just go in number 10, I guess. Oh, so another game like this, but with better graphics, is Forgotten Worlds. I think a game like Forgotten Worlds is actually a Commo game. Commo's good at those old school arcades. How do we get this one on? Well, there we go. We got a new weapon, guys. Well, that's pretty cool, isn't it? Good morning, Rich. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. We got Dave in here, too. There you go. As you can see, guys, I started with a game that I was good at, and then I just tried to come on with the, you know, take a risk. I hope this game is worth the risk. Shooty, shooty, and all that. There's a lot of shooty, shooty in this one. That's for damn sure. There's been no health pickups the last couple levels. Seriously. I really, really dig the music in this game. It's part of the reason I put it on, to be honest. There's an arcade version of this game too, guys, but it's completely different. Like, it's nothing like this. There is a universal HDMI switch box for RCA cords. My box is for composite, though. I have one for composite. I did have one for the RCA, but I think I accidentally threw it out. No, that's okay, Sylvain. We had a good run today. Well, let's see which way we're going to go now. Okay, well, we're still alive. That's the main thing. Let's have a look up here. Number 8. No, we're not going to go in number 8. That's taking us backwards. Alright, well, number 9 will do. There you go, Mariana. Good to see you. Thank you so much for hanging out. Fuck, I missed it. Damn, I keep missing the power-ups. No, that's okay. You like what you like. I can't get angry at you for having a favorite type of game or a favorite console. You know what I mean? That's what, you know, it'd be boring if we were all the same, my friend. I respect what you like very, very much. Well, there we go. We've got a shield here. Okay, what are we going to do now? I don't know. Let's have a look this way. I'm saved anyway. Oh, we're going back to... No, we're not going back to 6. You better get that. No, I accidentally hit the save state. I'm back to number 6. Oh, hang on. I think we're supposed to go to number 6 because now we've beaten that mini boss. That little elevator. You know how you got the elevators at the end? There was one in the red before, but I think now it's going to go green because we beat that mini boss. So there was a blocked path here before that's going to be open. I think we can go in that red... See? That red one that's left? There we go. That's where we need to be. See, I told you, there's a lot of mazes in this. Freaking handful, mate. This game is hard, but I like it, man. I used to always play this as a kid. This was something I used to play in the mornings. My mum used to work, and I'd be home by myself in the mornings, and this was one of those games that would take up a lot of my time. When I was about 10, 11... something to do. Oh, we got this. Come on, you sumbish. Yeah, I never got into it. That's not my type of game, but I can understand the appeal, Sylvain. Oh my gosh. Alright, let's see where we're going now. You think there's shades of Silver Surfer? Yeah, this is not... At least you... I guess you could say this is like a Silver Surfer on training wheels. Oh, I see. Can you use it without an SD card mod, D-Wade? I'm just curious. Like, can you use it without it, or is it only for the SD card mod? We We need to go here. What we got? So that was 14. What's this one up here? Just double checking. Nah, we're gonna go for 14, I think. Why not? Sorry, guys. There you go. Running the mazes. You can see this is nowhere near as hard as Silver Surfer, D-Wayne. Same gameplay, though. Oh, there we go. That was a hidden, like, room that I just missed. You see that little, little swirly thing? That was a hidden room, and I forgot to go in it. Ah, yeah, how good is it, man? I've got it on a physical disc, obviously, Sylvain. You know how much I love that game. I'll stream it for you again as a bonus one day. Oh, no! Pablo says WWE's Howard Finkel just passed away. That's a real shame. He can't have been that old. Poor guy. Oh, well, you know what? I'm kind of happy for him. I feel like he's in a better place now. Especially with everything that's freaking going on. That's a shame, though, for us. Everyone left behind, of course. How you going there, Shawnee? Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Hey, D-Wayne's actually pretty decent at Silver Surfer, my friends. There we go here. We totally could cheese it because we had the good weapon. Oh, I see. Ah, okay. I'm going to get all the details off you afterwards, D-Wayne, and then I'm going to search for exactly what I need on eBay. No worries. Yeah, I didn't think he was that old, Pablo. Yeah, absolutely, Mikey. Oh, we're in number... Oh, there we go. Now what? Absolutely, Mikey. Here we go. New area. I guess this is going to probably hopefully take us to the boss soon. Gosh, man. Well, what do you guys think of this game on first impressions? You enjoying it? You're like, eh? What do you guys think, honestly? As I said, I was just trying to do something a little bit different, so your honest feedback is A-okay. You know, sometimes I've got to remember to take chances, you know what I mean? And, you know, you some bitches are going to be like, we're just here to hang out with you. Yeah, but I want to put on a game you like, too. Susan says she likes it. As I said, it's a little bit more obscure. But as I said, there's nostalgia in this for me because I grew up with it. Well, let's see how we're going to go now. I don't know which way. Oh, this must be the boss room. Well, at least we're going to make it to World 2 today. I think they're on eBay, apparently, Errol. Yeah, I've got a physical copy of that, Mikey. This is totally like Gradius, this boss, huh? Open your big mouth. Open wide, come inside, it's one coin. There you go. That sounded ruder than what it was meant to. Oh, gosh. As I said, lucky I've got this rapid fire setting on too. Hey, we got Matthew here. Good to have you, Matthew. Thank you for hanging out. Appreciate you, my friend. Hope you're doing fantastic. There we go. We got that sucker. It's a shame, D-Wayne. Those obscure games just... You never know. You might get lucky next time. It depends on the day. The thing is, Silver Surfer is so infamous that sometimes that just gets a curiosity. Like, could you imagine if I had a stream that said... imagine if I did a stream that said Superman 64 full playthrough. I reckon I'd get a full room for that. Hypothetically, if that was even a thing. Here we go, new level. Oh, wait, section 20, so we're still going. This is like just one big endless level, isn't it? Here you go. This music in this level in particular sounds very Capcom-y, doesn't it? The music in this level could easily be in a Mega Man game. Like you could picture it, couldn't you? Let's go this way. This will do. Man, I really like the music in this. Oh man, Capcom always delivers on that department, don't they? Oh, it's a real shame. I didn't film my first playthrough of Space Harrier on the PlayStation 2, but I got up to the final level. Yeah, I actually passed four levels. I was pretty impressed too, D-Wayne. Oh, Errol just said he just fucked. Yeah, there you go. That was great timing, wasn't it? Errol just... Man, I've got more ticks than Sweet Anita, man. Errol just bought a laptop. What kind of laptop did you get, brother? I'm kind of curious of what everyone's running on their hardware, because, you know, I need more gear soon. Let's try again. This is freaking hard. How you going, Brian? It's a great game when you know how the fuck to play it. Man, okay. The problem is my dude was a little bit loose, and he wasn't... Doesn't matter. He wasn't controlling that smoothly. I kept running into stuff. Alright, let's do this again. Yeah, I had a few problems there. Let's try this again. This is kind of going into Silver Surfer territory. Yeah, this is... Oh, there we go. We got this spread gun. This is kind of like Contra vibes right now. This is cool. Dig in the Contra vibes. Yeah, I just heard Eric. It's a real shame, man. It's a real shame. He's Oh, dude, do you only get to... Oh. Where'd my spread gun go? He's along with Mean Gene, he was a voice of wrestling, wasn't he? Mean Gene behind the scenes and Howard Finkel in the ring. Oh, good on you, JR. I actually spent more money than I cared to admit on stuff on PS4 last night. Just some new games to stream, including Sonic Racing. Thought you guys might like that. What other games did I get to stream? I got some new stuff to stream anyway, put it that way. There's going to be more coming. But yeah, as I said, D-Wayne, I really want to get this Dreamcast, hey. I don't know, yeah. Yeah, I know. It's alright. Alright, level number 24, moving up in the world. There you go, we made it 24 levels today, guys. I mean, that's better than a kick in the head, isn't it? Got him. Matthew says Final Fantasy VII Remake has lived up to expectations. Dude, I think so, man. I really, really enjoy it, hey. I mean, I beat the game and it left me wanting more and I couldn't wait till the next part. So I guess it delivered, huh? I tell you what, the last 3 hours of that game was fucking cracker, bro. The boss battles were epic. The storytelling was epic. It was worth waiting for. Anyone else in here finished Final Fantasy VII yet? If not, what the hell are you doing? Mike says he always goes back to the classics and he plays more old school games than the new ones. Yeah, I'd say I'm probably about 75% old school over 25%. Ooh, guys, I'm really excited. I've got something to show you, by the way. And just before we continue with the game, and I feel a little bit guilty because I kind of splurged on this. This is officially the most expensive game in my collection, but I got it. It's released in Europe only. You know how I'm on a big... Resident Evil craze at the moment. I just got Resident Evil Survivor Code Veronica on PlayStation 2. This only got released in the European region, so it's PAL only. And oh my gosh, this ain't even that good a game, but it's pretty rare and it costs a pretty penny. And I don't usually splurge much on my collection, but I really wanted that game, so... I'm so happy that arrived safe, because I was very nervous about that one. So, I just thought I'd show you. I was really, really happy. It was a bit late, but it finally arrived today. It's kind of a rail shooter, yeah. It's another one of those rail shooter games. So, it'll be interesting to see if I can practice it and get half decent at it. Yeah. Yeah, that's it's PAL only, man. It runs fine on emulation, like you can play it on PCS, whatever the fudge it's called. So you can emulate it, but You know, I wanted it on the physical disc just so if I played it's perfect, no issues, you know. Thank you, Tony. Yeah, it's literally the most expensive game in my collection. Which, I'll probably tell you the price and you'll be like, oh, it's not that expensive, but, you know, for me it is. I love rail shooters. I can't wait one more week and I can play Darkside Chronicles again. I want to play Darkside Chronicles once a month. I love that game. You guys know how much I love that. Ooh, crap. Hey, Kenny, good morning to you too, man. Thank you for coming in. I'm just getting shot by these freaking volcanoes, mate. You know, no problem. Oh, what are we going to do here? I also got Outbreak Files too, just so you guys know. Outbreak Files is on the way. I mean, it arrived. By level 28. Oh, fantastic, Josh. Oh, man, no dramas. Thank you very, very much, man. Josh says he found some Dreamcast stuff for me. Yeah, I don't even mind if I have to get an American version. I've got, like, you know, that's fine. Thank you, Tony, for justifying my purchase. No worries, JR. Thank you, man. I just had to go all the way back to the start because I lost my health. That sucks. All right, you know what, guys? I'm going to do this one more time, and if we fail again, it's a bust. But I'm really struggling now. This game is getting freaking balls. Fuck off, I did. Hang on. Oh, my gosh. One coin's getting really pissed off here. Yeah, I've noted. Well, you know what? Yeah, they go from about $5 to $25 Australian, which is what? Yeah, about 15 US. And like you said, after that, they just freaking... You're not wrong. Morning, Nick. Thank you for coming in. Big thank you to everyone who liked and shared the stream. Appreciate that, guys. You know, I just lied to you. I'm actually dying on purpose just so I can listen to the music. Because, you know, it's awesome. Damn it, I'm sick of fucking dying every 2 fucking seconds. Oh my gosh, this game is freaking balls. This is getting Silver Surfer hard now, D-Wayne. Yeah, I hope we get a dream cut. Oh no, thank you, Joshy. But that's not necessary, dude. I'm just happy for you to show me. And I can get him sent here directly. You're good. But man, I really, really appreciate that gesture. But no, you're... Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Oh, dude. Okay, no, that's it. That's a rage quit. I'm gonna do a bonus game before I leave. I've lost half my room because I suck at that game too much. All right, guys. I'm gonna do a bonus game. Actually, I'm not going to do that one. No, I don't feel like doing that as a bonus. No, okay, no, we'll do this as a bonus game. Actually, no, I'm going to play the Japanese version. I think I've got the Japanese version here. Hang on. Where's it? Here we go. We're going to do the Japanese version. I don't know if it's any different. But here we go, Spartan X. Hey, go on, Steve. Good to see you. Thank you for coming in. Oh, here we go. Bonus game. I got too stuck on Section Z. That was a failed risk. No worries, it happens. we'll just do a full playthrough of this. Ah, oh, damn it. And Nick says OG Final Fantasy is like $35. Yeah, that's about how much it starts from about $50 Australian over here and then goes up. There was a lot of copies of that. That's why, it's expensive, but not as expensive as you'd think. There you go. Pablo's happy because I'm doing the Famicom version. Spartan X. Apparently this is supposed to be Jackie Chan. I did not know that. Did you know the main character in this game is Jackie Chan? I didn't. Main character is Jackie Chan. Apparently this is based on one of his movies or shows or something. Who knew, huh? I had no idea. So, I mean, you know, they in the English version, they call it Thomas. But, yeah, it's Jackie Chan, apparently. I always thought it was just Thomas. Yeah, it was Dwayne, but in Japan only. So you have to import it. As far as I know. But I think it's got a different name over there, maybe. Yeah, we'll have to work that out. That'll probably cost you a pretty penny. Hey, welcome back, Honkus. Oh, yeah, I just did some Kid Icarus, and I did some Section Z, which was a complete fail. And, now we're just doing a bonus game. I don't think I picked the right games this morning for Facebook to be happy at me, but that's okay. It's alright, Facebook, I'll tug on your cock again one day. Sorry, that was a bit rude, wasn't it? I'm sorry, guys, I've got no filter, hey. I'm just, man, I just say what's on my mind. It's gonna get me in a lot of trouble one day. Oh, well, I hope you find it entertaining and not offensive, at least. Yeah, we beat Kid Icarus pretty quick, only in 75 minutes. What other retro games on NES do you guys like that I haven't done in a while? I'm kind of curious. I'm on a bit of an NES kick right now. What other NES games would you like to see? Not ones with big learning curves, though. Like, don't say games like Star Tropics and things like that that take 50 hours to learn. I just mean, like, basic NES games. You know a boat named Old Tugger? Yeah, it belongs to Russell Crowe. We're going to try and do a couple loops. Alright, there we are. Wonder if I got as far as what I did that time in Section Z last time. I feel like we got further. Super Dodgeball. Yeah, I can learn how to play Super Dodgeball a bit more, I guess. I've got to remember how to do the special moves. I've forgotten. Oh wait, you gotta run and then throw to do the power attacks, don't you? I have played Bubble Bobble. I kind of prefer the arcade version over the NES version, though, myself, Mikey. Yeah, Ryan actually just said the same thing. Ryan just said he loves himself some Bubble Bobble. There is a remake that's either coming out or has just come out, apparently. I'm gonna have to look into that. D-Wayne says he loves my original Zelda runs. Oh, man. I might have to do, like, a live walkthrough. Like, telling people exactly what I'm doing and... I don't know. I kind of feel bad. Like, I'm really, really, really solid at Zelda 1. But then there's some bitches that speedrun it in 20 minutes. So it's like... That's just next level. Oh, it was on the Switch, that's right. Yeah, I love Zelda. I'm trying to spread my Zelda runs out a little bit more now. Like, you know, being streaming every week for... You know, I'm fortunate that we've added a lot more games to the library. So, you know, some of those games that I was doing, like, all the time can simmer for a little bit and feel special again when I do them. So, Sylvain says his favorite Zelda Hack's Adventure of Error. That's my favorite, too. I love it. I love the adult humor in that. It is a missed opportunity, Dwayne. Some people have no concept of business, right? Nick says, do Zelda 2 offline and then stream it. Oh, what do you mean? Do a playthrough and then explain what I'm doing? You know, that's not a bad idea. Maybe one day. The Legend of Zelda 2 Masterclass. I might, you know what I might do? I might do a special Zelda 2 stream and teach people the easy way to do the difficult bosses. I'm not very good against the blue light knights though, so with those you're on your own. I might do some tutorials and on that. So, yeah, oh, that's right, we're gonna do Kirby's Nightmare eventually, don't we? Yeah, we'll do some Kirby soon. I like Kirby on the NES, but I prefer to play the Game Boy Advance version because it's got the 16-bit graphics. So, yeah, we might smash that one out pretty soon, Mike. I keep forgetting to play Kirby, I really want to do it soon. Yeah, we'll do some Kirby soon, for sure. I just did Simon's Quest the other day, Steve. I did Simon's Quest literally, was it yesterday or the day before? No, it was the day before. You missed it, Steve. You didn't watch. If you want nice things, Steven, then you have to fucking watch them. I'm not really angry, Steve. I'm not that crazy, I promise. Damn, Mike, you're like my friend Andrew. You play a lot of games, my friend. Here we go. This is the Aussie boss over here. It's Steve Irwin. Oh, crikey, look at that. We got him. No, that's okay, Steve. You know I do Simon's Quest once a month. It's not going to be the last time. It'll be a minute before I feel like I'm on a Simon's Quest kick again. I'm just not feeling like it now that I've done it. I actually had a really bad run of Simon's Quest yesterday. I got it, yeah. April, thank you, girl. April's going to bed. What do we got for April before she leaves? April, this one's going out to you. You have a wonderful sleep. We'll see you tomorrow, girl. I'm not too far behind. You take care, chick. I'm not too far behind you, trust me. I've got about 5 minutes. Maybe a little bit longer. It depends how long I last in this, actually. David says this was the first game you ever... Oh, this was on PC too? You know, I've played the NES version. I have played the arcade version. Arcade version was actually at my laundromat growing up. Man, that was hard as balls. And I have also played... the Atari 2600 version. Believe it or not, this game is on Atari 2600. And that version is actually surprisingly solid. You wouldn't think so. But the Atari version of this, even with one button, is fun to play. Definitely give it a chance. Fuck-a-doo. There you go. Bastard. Excuse me. Dude, don't you even think about it. Get out of here, one coin. Come on, Jackie Chan. The Kid Jackson says you lost so many quarters to this game. I have only beat the arcade version once, Kid Jackson. And that was putting all the dip switches onto easy, and even then I've only done it once. These old arcade games have dip switches where you can change the difficulty. And, like, you can put these old arcade games on easy. That's just a big troll. They're not easy. They're never easy. Like, you've got hell hard, very hard, or somewhat hard. No, actually, no, that's a bit too generous as well. No, I get you, Mikey. I know exactly what that feels like. Dustin says, oh, you like the Castlevania 5 hack? I like that one too. We're going to do a Castlevania trilogy stream again soon. I'll go through the first three games. I'll do some Castlevania hacks again soon, though. Ones that I haven't played in a bit. Fuck-a-dee. Okay, here we go. Let's keep going. How you going there, Nate? Good to see you. These are wizard levels always. Fuck off, you stupid lady mother bitch bugs. These stupid lady bugs are not social distancing. Alright, we're going... Ugh. There have been terrible social distances. Alright, Carl, we can do this. Fuckadoo. Fuckadoo. Oh my gosh. What are you laughing at, fucktard? Shut up. Try this again. We only got two lives left. I'm going to be doing Resident Evil 3 Remake in a few days. I'm up to Nightmare difficulty, and I've now unlocked everything I need, so we're going to try again. But not for a few days. I want to mix things up a bit, you know? I'm going to be doing a Star Wars themed stream, as I said, tomorrow. Excuse me. And I don't know what I'll do for the late night stream yet. We'll see. You never know. Maybe Resi for the late night, but I don't know. There we go. We actually made it, guys. Wow. There we go. It looks like we're going to make loop number two today. So, Josh says, have I streamed Bloodstained Ritual of the Night yet? Josh, I have. But that was like a year ago already. I really, 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 really love that game. I played the whole thing on stream with about a 95% completion. So we did the job. My only problem with Bloodstained is it wasn't a trending game. And so it's a big commitment, and it didn't really help the page grow any, unfortunately. Which is a real shame, because I've been looking forward to playing it again, but it just never had that, oh man, everyone must watch kind of vibe, unfortunately, which breaks my heart. I wish I could just play the games I want to play all the time, but I can't. I wish it was that easy. Sean, did you just come in the room, Sean? Because I was just telling my other friend, I did Simon's Quest just yesterday. That's actually the second time I've been asked that in 5 minutes. You guys, if you snooze, you lose. We just did Simon's Quest like 2 days ago. Yeah, no, I did Simon's Quest 2 days ago. You must have just come in, Sean. Welcome to the stream. No, that's okay. It's a big coincidence. I guess people really like Castlevania 2, huh? Yeah, no, we smashed it. But it's alright. I usually do that game on the monthly. This is our final life, by the way, guys. We're about to get some Nookie, though. There you go. Come on, Jackie Chan. You got this. Alright, cool. Let's see how long we can make this final life last, eh? Well, damn, Sean. Sean, wow. Well, I mean, wow. That's certainly some hardcore gaming if I've ever heard it. By the way, Sean, that is really, really kind of you, my man. Thank you so much. Sean just dropped the 500 stars. I really, really appreciate you, man. And, man, Sean here did some partying in the 80s. You must have watched some of this, too, back in the day.
You're really in for a treat. I mean, besides me. We're going to take a look at Hollywood's ultimate bad girls.
Thank you so much, Sean. I really appreciate you. That's very kind of you, my friend. Don't worry, Sean. If you hang around, we will do, over the coming weeks, we'll do Simon's Quest again. Raining stars this morning too. I know. I'm feeling very, very blessed. I've been well looked after. Hey, you do like Elvira. That was a good guess, wasn't it? Oh, booby, yes. But this is my final life, guys. We're going to make this last as long as we can. I think the final boss is just okay. Each level has 6 parts. Now, if you're wondering what all those signs say, they actually say 1 to 6 in Chinese characters. So that's actually the number 5. And here's the number six. The boss is always at number six. So yeah. Mule on Wheels is the movie this game was based on. Oh, okay, gotcha. Gosh, we live to fight another day. Hey, this is the furthest I've actually been off one game in a while, actually. Oh, how you going, Faraj? Nice, man. I'm glad you're going to get home. We're almost done here, man. I've actually got to go to bed nice and early and prepare for tomorrow's streaming because I'm playing some pretty hard games in the morning. I want to be all prepared for you guys. We got Jeremy in here. Good to see you, Jeremy. Thank you for hanging out, man. Yeah, they're all numbered 1 to 6 in Chinese. I only know that because in like 5th grade I did like Chinese for 2 minutes and I somehow remembered it. I think it's pretty cool that I remember that far back. So Mike says, what's my favorite kung fu action movie? That's actually a really good question. Probably Enter the Dragon. Probably Bruce Lee, man. Probably Enter the Dragon if I had to pick specifically kung fu. But there's a lot of fighting movies I like. If you're talking fighting movies, then, you know, you've got, like, Bloodsport and Kickboxer and all that, too. But if you're talking, like, the kung fu stuff, I'd probably say Enter the Dragon. What about you guys? What's everyone else's favorite kung fu movie? I'd like to see more Jackie Chan movies, I have to admit. I've not seen a lot of Jackie Chan movies, just his crazy ass stunts where he's hurt himself. Like Legend of the Drunken Master, Drunken Fist, eh? No, that's okay, Jeremy. I'm glad you got the rest. You obviously needed it. You also like The Last Dragon. Okay, gotcha. So Peyron says there's too many kung fu movies to name the favorite. If you ask me specifically, like, just fighting movies, then yeah, 100%. So Sean says he's a big Jackie Chan fan. Well, Kill Bill is a fantastic movie, isn't it? I haven't seen Kill Bill in so long that if I watched it again, it'd probably be really fresh. Yeah, Jackie Chan's a stunt master, man. There we go. I can't believe we're still alive here, guys. This is going forever. Oh, is it really Josh? Josh says that famous scene from Enter the Dragon is his Google. Well, there you go. That is a pretty famous scene, isn't it? The mirror maze and everything. That was really well filmed. That was pretty incredible. Like, when I see that now, it still blows me away. Damn it. Oh, well, I'm dead. Fuck you, Rick. Game over. Alright guys, well thank you so much for coming in. That was a little bit of an interesting stream today. We did pretty well with Kid Icarus. Section Z was a little bit of a flop today, but you live and learn. And then we just finished with a bonus game, Kung Fu. As I said, I just like to take chances sometimes and try and introduce new games into the lineup. It's easier said than done, but I'm working on it, guys. I just want you to have as much content as possible. But guys, thank you very much for watching the stream. Really appreciate all of you guys. D-Wayne's going to be streaming Mortal Kombat 9 in the afternoon on Headlock Gaming. Make sure you check him out. Then he's going to be doing the VIP stream for all you supporters. Don't forget to click on that green shield if you haven't at 6 p.m. He'll be doing the regular stream at 7 p.m. and then I'll be on at 10 p.m. Eastern all night doing a Star Wars themed stream. So grab your lightsabers out for that. But much love to you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Let's see who's online. And we might do a little raid here, hey? Let's see what we got. Well, there's no one on, apparently. I'm trying to look, but no one is apparently on. I'm going to... Yeah, no one... No one is on, unfortunately. Oh, well, I can't raid anyone. Anyway, we'll do it next time, guys. Take care. I'll see you soon.